Nick Corey from New York City, grew up?
Yeah, I was born there. Grew up in New Jersey and Miami and California.
Really?
Yeah.
New Jersey, Miami, and California.
Yeah.
A mixture. New York, though. Great memories as a child. Growing up there. Rough.
New Jersey, yeah.
You say New Jersey. No, mostly New Jersey. Okay.
New York was basically born at the hospital. I remember that.
Uh-huh. So you're a New Jersey boy, then?
Yeah, I'm a Jersey boy.
Uh-huh.
But New York came later. During my 18, 19, 20, 21, uh-huh. Spent time there.
When did Nick Corey decide that he wanted to be an actor?
It was in Los Angeles. Had a good friend of mine show me a teen magazine mm-hmm. with Scott Baio on the cover.
Right.
When he was doing Happy Days.
Right.
And he said, would you want to do this? We were trying to find out, break down what I wanted to do when I grew up. You know, uh-huh. What should I have focused?
How old were you then, Nick? Because you're young
13.
Now.
13.
13?
13.
So you knew at 13 you wanted to be...
Yeah. When I saw Scott Baio on the cover, I said, that's what I want. And what had happened is I was on most of the teen magazines when I was 19 with the movie Gotcha. Uh-huh. And then I had to refocus and get a new goal because uh-huh. I completed what I said I was going to do. I was going to uh-huh. be on the cover.
Uh-huh. And so you say Gotcha. That wasn't your first film.
No.
What was your first film?
A Nightmare on Elm Street, Part 1.
Part 1 of Nightmare on Elm Street.
With Johnny Depp.
Right. What did you play in that?
I played Rod Lane, uh-huh. punk rocker. They thought I was the murderer, you know, uh-huh. if you saw the movie. And
Did you have to read for that part? Or
yes.
Did they just pick you up?
Yes. I read for Wes. I was frustrated. I haven't gotten a job. I did Fame, the TV show.
Right.
And I didn't work for 3 years.
Uh-huh.
I was going to give it up, and I went in frustrated, which was perfect for the character.
Right.
He was a frustrated guy, mm-hmm. and I got the role. Uh-huh. And then from that point on, Johnny Depp told me back in the dressing room of Nightmare on Elm Street, there's a movie called Gotcha. You should be up for it.
Right.
I went and read for it, got the movie Gotcha.
Uh-huh. Who's in that?
It was Anthony Edwards,
uh-huh.
Alex Rocco, uh-huh. me, and... Linda Ferrantino.
Ah.
Linda Ferrantino.
Yes. So that's the front cover and all the teen
yeah.
covers from that film? All the girls?
Universal did a massive marketing on it.
Right.
But the movie went nowhere.
Uh-huh.
It went straight to cable. And, mm-hmm. and then actually it was resurrected in cable. Thank God.
Mm-hmm. Study acting. I look back at your career, studied with the best. Look, Peggy Fury. Mm-hmm. Great. Stella Adler.
Great lady.
Great.
Great lady.
And you had another one. Great.
Yeah, John Abbott.
John Abbott.
Shakespeare with John Abbott.
You studied Shakespeare.
Great character actor.
Study Shakespeare. I'm looking at you.
Come on.
Why Shakespeare? Why?
I heard, you know, an actor's thing when you're starting out. If you do Shakespeare, you can do anything.
Right.
And, of course, my idols were Marlon Brando and et cetera, and, uh-huh. and those guys had done Shakespeare. They did Julius Caesar.
Uh-huh.
He did the best Mark Anthony I've ever seen. And I thought, well, she's...
How many times have you seen that movie?
I saw it about 4 or 5 times.
I knew. Young kids like you rent those movies and study them, right?
Oh, yeah. I
is Marlon Brando your favorite? He's the greatest actor in
yes,
the world.
Yes, he used to be. Now my favorite is Tom Hanks is uh-huh. one of them. Eric Roberts. Tom Hanks is one of the most genius uh-huh. Actors I've seen.
Peggy Fury.
Yes.
Great lady.
Yeah, I loved her.
And her husband, great.
Yeah, Bill. Bill Traylor.
Tell me about studying with Peggy Fury. What technique did she have? Did she have the actor's studio technique, or did she? What technique did she have?
Well, I've never been to the actor's studio, but I had heard the Loft Studio.
Right.
At the time was happening. Everybody went to the Loft Studio. I went to Loft Studio. I had been with Vincent Chase.
Right.
And I wanted to move on, and that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to hit everybody.
Uh-huh.
And the Loft Studio was happening. Peggy Fury was hot, and you had to go through Bill Traylor.
Right.
And my interpretation of
which
it
was her husband.
Which was her husband.
Right.
He sort of break you down and mold you mm-hmm. and prepare you for Peggy's class.
Uh-huh.
And breaking down means just get rid of all those bad habits, you know, eyebrow acting and
uh-huh.
you know.
And listening.
Yeah, you know, self-conscious with the hands, putting them in your pocket, and using crutches and smoking, and eventually prepare you for Peggy's class, and I did. I graduated, went to Peggy's class.
Right.
I just loved her, you know, I just loved to watch her twirl her pearls and...
Who are some of the students in your class? Some of the
group. Nick Cage.
Nick Cage was with?
Sean Penn. James Wilder.
She's had the best. She's had the best.
The girl that's being nominated now for Best Actress.
You mean
Rambling
Dern.
Rose?
Rambling Rose. Laura Dern.
Laura Dern was there.
Yeah, she's great.
And there was then the advance class.
Right.
Thursday, which I got to go to a couple of them. Which was Meg Tilly. And many more. I mean, I don't remember.
You brought me a clip from one of your...
Meg Ryan.
Yes, right. She's great. Yeah. You brought me a clip from one of your early movies.
Yes.
I love it. I saw it, and I just love to show it. Slaves of New York.
Slaves of New York. Great.
Tell me about... Set up this clip we're going to do.
Well, this is... I play an artist who is dying to get Bernadette Peters to... He wants to make a sculpture of her.
Right.
And draw her.
Right.
And this is not Bernadette Peters. My best friend, I sleep with his girlfriend.
Right.
And this girl, and I'm trying to get rid of her. And this is his girlfriend because I'm my friend.
Good.
How could I do that?
Let's see it. Slaves of New York. Okay.
I bought you a chicken.
Yeah.
Can I come up?
No.
What?
No.
And some chocolate.
You can't come up. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, you look adorable today.
Well, I thought you'd like this chicken.
Hey, listen. This isn't gonna work out, Daria. I'm sorry.
You don't want me coming upstairs?
Did you say you have some chocolates?
Truffles.
I'll just taste one. You don't want that chicken?
It's for you.
Well, I don't want the chicken to go to waste. Gotta go!
Hey! Wait a second!
Thanks for the chicken.
Hey, listen!
The only one of his I ever really liked was that one with Marat killed over in the bathtub.
Yeah, I gotta tell you something. That's a great political thing.
That's not great because of his politics. It's great because of his human drama.
How can you say that?
Oh, listen, you don't think art can be great unless it assumes some kind of political or
philosophical... Because I'm trying to say something, unlike you, just pisses on canvas.
Piss on canvas.
Get us some wood, please.
Morning. You're gonna miss your plane.
Oh, shit. I gotta run. Hey, man, I owe you some bucks.
No, forget it, man.
Here, it's on Chuck Dave Dolger. Look, Sherman, I gotta tell you, I slept with Daria.
I know. She told me.
Well, I knew you knew.
Hey, Molly, be cool.
See you later.
Really great.
Thank you.
Short Eyes. Tell me about Short Eyes.
Short Eyes.
You did the play Short Eyes here in Los Angeles.
Yes, I did.
I love that show. You were very young in it.
Very young. I think I was 17, and I did Short Eyes at the Fig Tree Theater.
And you got an award.
99, you got Dramalog Best Acting Achievement Award that they give out every year.
For the youngest actor in Hollywood.
Yeah.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Yeah, I was blown away, actually. Yeah.
You're a fine actor, Nick.
Thank you.
I saw you in this wonderful movie I'm going to tell the people later, but you were just, you blew me away, actually, because it was so great. Your acting is so good and for a young guy. And you ride horses. You train horses. Just tell me about your horses.
Yeah, to keep me sane, so I don't sit at home and.
So you're not just an actor.
Well, I try not to be because it just drives me crazy to sit by the phone and please, you know,
right.
What's the next job? I gotta do.
Is it really tough for a young actor like yourself?
Yeah, it is. I'm not gonna say it's easy. It's like trying to keep your mind, you know, try to get focused and sane, and then go out and get a job, and then you don't work, and then you got to get another job, and then, so I go off and do horses, thank God to my friend JR, and he said, why don't you go work with horses? I'll teach you how to ride, and for the Institute of Individual World Peace. They have
the World Peace?
Yeah, Individual World Peace.
Right.
The Institute has 140 acres. And apart from doing many things, they have horses. And I learned how to ride there for nothing, for free. I learned how to ride there and train their horses. Mm-hmm. And there's several processes that we do, and one of them is imprinting.
Imprinting? What's
yes,
that?
Yes, it's trying to work with a horse when you're going to ride them for the first time. Mm-hmm. Basically give them love and touching them all over and petting them without having to jump on them right away and having them buck you off and breaking their spirit. It's all done. I've broke eight horses, and only one of them bucked me once, which uh-huh. you'll see in the clip.
Right.
And apart from training them, I like to goof around and uh-huh. get on their backs, roll them over. Uh-huh. I like to imprint colts, fillies, when they first are born.
I like the word imprint, that word.
Yes. You imprint, you touch them all over, you touch them in the ears.
And they remember that from the birth?
That's you'll see at the end of the clip, you'll see about five white mares running with their fillies, mm-hmm. With their colts. And what we do is, as soon as they're born, we grab them and touch them all over and uh-huh. everywhere. So by the time they get to about 4 or 5 years old, you can go up to them, put your finger in their mouth,
right.
and they're gonna bite you. You can touch their butt, they won't kick. And just get them humanized.
Let's see that clip.
Okay.
Would you? Show that clip of this. I love
and
to
I'll
see
talk.
It. And you'll talk,
sure.
Of course, go ahead.
Right here, we're just joking around in uh-huh. the stall.
How
that's
cute.
A brand new colt. Mm-hmm. And what aww. I do is I lay down with them, I roll them over, I get them used to me, get them uh-huh. used to everybody. Here I am for the first time getting on a horse with a saddle.
This is your first time?
Yeah, okay. On this horse.
Uh-huh.
And this is what happens when you rush. This was my fault, I rushed.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
But later, I broke them with kindness. With kindness. Right here, you
how
let them
how do you break them with kindness?
You just love them.
Love them?
Here it is, working with another horse, and you walk sideways with them and get them to do uh-huh. all sorts of tricks.
Uh-huh.
Here's our favorite stallion, Yuri the Fury.
Uh-huh.
And he's special. He's like a human. Here, I get the lead rope.
Uh-huh.
I clip the lead rope on him. He'll take the lead rope by his mouth, and he'll follow me.
Uh-huh. Now, what kind of horse is this?
This is an Arabian stallion, Egyptian Arabian,
uh-huh.
one of the best.
Beautiful
great
horse.
Blood.
Oh, look at that horse.
And he just loves you, you know?
Nick, you seem very happy and content. Like, look at this man, very happy.
This is what keeps me sane.
Uh-huh.
And here are the mares.
Oh, aren't they beautiful?
Who have just given birth to, there's
look
about five of them.
That, oh.
And you'll see this, her son, mm-hmm. Saqqara.
Right.
After the Egyptian pyramid. Uh-huh. Will run right behind her and not watch where she's going.
Uh-huh.
Right here.
Isn't that great?
Here we go.
Oh. That's beautiful, Nick.
Ladies and gentlemen, and boom.
Oops. Oh, that's cute. That's wonderful, Nick. That's really great. You enjoy getting up early in the morning, working out these horses. How early do you get up in the morning?
I don't get up that early. I get up around 10.
Oh, no. Don't you get up early and take care of these horses?
No, the staff that works up there that handle the
in Santa Barbara?
Yeah, they handle the everyday, thank God. They do the hay, they do the grooming.
Because I know, Cece Houston.
Yeah,
oh, a friend
that's
of mine.
A lot of work.
She gets up and she grooms them and does.
I just go up there on the weekends.
Uh-huh.
And I can give about 2 days. I go up there and work with them and uh-huh. love them. And
do you jump? Do you jump
I'm
horse?
Learning how to. I have an Australian saddle. It sort of holds you in.
Uh-huh.
And you can go jump and jumping is takes talent. I'm not yet.
So this gets you away from show business and gets you sane, right to your foot, huh?
Exactly. And the other thing that I'm using this too is, if a Western comes along, I'll be able to, you know, use this. I uh-huh. utilize the talents of horseback riding.
You like Westerns? Do you like
Westerns?
Why is our movies don't have Westerns today?
I don't know, but
we've
got to talk to these guys and get the John Waynes out
there. Nah, you got to talk to the young casting directors and
right.
the young writers don't want to write these films.
I know.
They don't want to write. Why? You're a young guy. Tell me, why don't they want to write these films?
I want Westerns to come back, musicals to come back, the old MGM grand epics, uh-huh. musicals, you know.
You're old Hollywood, I think,
I
Nick.
I am.
Huh? Basically, you're old Hollywood. You?
I love those old movies. I love Cleopatra, El Cid, uh-huh. Ben-Hur. They don't make them like
how about writing? Are you writing at all? Like Stallone did a movie and all that? Are you writing as a young actor?
I gotta tell you, I'm not a good writer. I'm more audible. I like to hear or visually see. I'm not uh-huh. A sit-down kind of guy. Although I haven't tried it. You know, I'm not. Uh-huh. I haven't tried it.
Is Nick spiritual?
Yeah, I'm not religious.
Are you married or?
I used to be. I was divorced.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, chalk one.
Have a girl right now?
Yeah. Yeah, I got a girl.
Uh-huh. Good-looking guy like you. God, you must get a lot. This picture you just did with Sally Kirkland.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on.
Make love four times.
You made love what?
Four times.
Four times.
With Sally Kirkland.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In this hot movie.
Excellent movie. Excellent love scenes.
Right, right. Yeah. Tell me about that picture, The Heat.
Well, it's called In the Heat of Passion, directed by Rodman Flender.
Uh-huh.
And it's Concord, Roger Corman. Thank God he's giving me great opportunities to
Roger
work.
Roger has helped you a lot,
yeah,
hasn't he?
Yeah, gave me two movies.
Let's see the first one.
Lawless Land.
Who was in that?
It was just me, and that's it.
Uh-huh.
And I forgot the other actors.
Right, actors.
I don't know.
So Roger Corman's movies are, this one's a hot movie. I saw this at the premiere with Sally Kirkland and you, and I said, uh-oh, I got to use you on my show.
It's a great stepping stone.
You're a Tyrone Power, mixture with Johnny Garfield, mixture with your old Hollywood.
That would be a good movie to make, Blood in the Sand.
Yeah, Blood in the Sand with Tyrone Power.
But to make it again.
Yeah, as Nick Corey.
Yeah.
Nick, let's
show
this.
Okay.
Tell me more about the Sally Kirkland scene. Now,
well,
this particular.
I think this is the bar scene.
Okay.
I'm just hot for her. This is like a Postman Always Rings Twice. She seduced me. I'm hot for her. She knows it. I'm chasing her, and here she is teasing me.
Okay, let's see.
That's asparagus.
In the heat of passion.
Than I could ever hope to process. The way I look at it is if they're dumb enough to take the job, then they must be dumb enough to be able to handle it.
That's a good way of putting it.
Tell us, dear, how is your work going? Well, actually, I...
Waiter, another round here.
I'm telling you, if anyone... Betty doesn't understand. She just laughs anyway.
For a minute, please. I have to go powder my nose.
Is she feeling okay?
Well, Lee, something's got into her lately. I don't know.
God, that's great. Looks like door one, door two, door three.
Bob Barker.
And there she was, door three. Working with Sally Kirkland. Boy, what a hot lady.
Yeah, very hot.
She is her best PR. What makes Sally Kirkland work so hard in the best PR?
She's the best.
Isn't she?
She's done a heck of a job with this movie. And,
uh-huh.
And
you've had some hot scenes.
Yeah. I'm really thankful for her. It was her that gave me the break to get this movie.
You tell me one scene you had to take all your clothes off, both of you.
Yeah.
In one scene.
Yeah.
Tell me about that scene.
Well, we were, you know, a little bit uncomfortable. We were all both naked. Not all naked, but both naked.
Uh-huh.
And the director said, what should we do? And I said, well, you know, Last Tango in Paris. Why don't we do that?
Right, right.
So that's what we did. We crossed legs with each other and got up like that.
She's
in a way, it covers the two obvious parts, and
Sally's green for everything. She teaches acting, doesn't she?
Yes, she does. I think so.
You're in the same organization she's in. What is that called? The John, you gave me a book before.
Yeah, John Roger.
John Rogers.
I read his books. I love his books called Life 101.
Uh-huh.
You can't afford the luxury of a negative thought.
So you're in that.
Yeah, and I'm not. Yeah, I'm in, meaning I. Yeah, I love that
right,
work.
Right.
I love it. And
does Sally get you into that? Or did you?
No, I got into it
you
before.
You got into it before?
I never knew she was in it.
I see.
I was doing my thing and
uh-huh.
and spiritually trying to get focused and keep a sane head and I read books like Do It, Let's Get Off Your Butts, Do the Right Thing uh-huh. And get uh-huh. healthy spiritually, mentally, whatever. And then somebody told me Sally Kirkland.
Uh-huh.
She was being nominated that year for Anna.
Right, Anna, right.
And then that's when I met her.
I see.
And John Roger introduced us and then Sally says, we gotta work one day.
Uh-huh. Hollywood's tough out here, isn't it, Nick?
It sure is.
You don't go to clubs,
no.
Hang out with people,
no.
All that. You don't do it.
No.
You're a loner?
Kind of.
Basically?
Kind of. I did it when I was in my teens and 20s,
uh-huh.
early 20s. Now I'm 28. I don't smoke cigarettes anymore.
Great.
So when I go to clubs, unless they have a non-smoking club, I'm going.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
But now I don't go because it's smoky and.
So Nick Corey's not the Hollywood scene guy. You're really basically.
I think Hollywood has different sections for those kind of people.
I see.
Smoking Hollywood, hey, I'll go over there.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not going to go smoke, you know. And it doesn't bother me when people smoke.
David Carradine, let's get back.
David
did a movie with
Love
David Carradine.
Love it.
Tell me about that film you did with David.
Tropical Snow, me and Madeline Stowe.
Mm-hmm.
I think you've seen her in Revenge with Kevin Costner. She and I played
Sally
lovers.
Was in that too.
No.
Wasn't Sally Kirkland
yes,
in that?
Yes, Revenge she was.
Of course, she played the prostitute at the bar.
Yes,
right,
great scene. And Tropical Snow, me and Madeline Stowe play mulas, which mean in Latin America means cocaine smugglers. They eat cocaine,
right.
Wait till they get to New York or
uh-huh.
America, and then
uh-huh.
go to the bathroom, and then they got a kilo. That's uh-huh. what we did for visas. And David Carradine plays the mafioso guy that pushes it on us
mm-hmm.
and makes sure that I do it and that she does it.
Uh-huh.
Which results in deaths and unhappiness.
Nick Corey, Hollywood's tough. Would you like to? I don't know. There's a lot of great movies out there not being filmed.
Yeah.
In the can. What would you like to do? I mean, is there something? Who did you, first of all, who did you look up to when you were a child? You say
Dean
it's
Martin.
Dean Martin? Really?
Yeah, Matt Helm movies.
Uh-huh.
You know, when he was had that round bed that would spin around, put on a Dean Martin song, champagne would come down,
uh-huh.
and his girl.
What's the role that Nick Corey would like to do you haven't done so far?
Well, I always want to have a spiritual connection. I always want to just be who I am. That's what I want to be
who
first.
Who is Nick Corey? Do you know who Nick Corey is?
I'm learning every day. But I'd like to do that, and as I do that, the movies I would like to do, one of them would be biblical movies. Like I'd love to do King David or,
uh-huh.
or Solomon,
mm-hmm.
do those kind of movies, or a Shakespeare movie or a cowboy movie.
Mm-hmm. You did a Shakespeare play.
No.
No.
No, I did Shakespeare school. I went to with John Abbott.
Uh-huh.
But I'd never done a play. John Abbott.
In New York?
In L.A.
In L.A.?
Yeah.
Was it here in L.A.?
For 10 years.
At that Shakespearean theater, we have a good one here in L.A., don't we?
Yeah, I think the Old Globe.
The Old Globe.
Yeah.
You've done plays there?
No, I auditioned for Julius Caesar, and I auditioned for Cassius, and I was too young.
Uh-huh.
But it would have been perfect because he's lean and hungry.
Tell me about Facts of Life. You've done so many television guest appearances. Facts of Life, Bronx Zoo, Miami Vice. You've been on Miami Vice.
Miami Vice with Don Johnson.
Don Johnson, working with Don Johnson.
I love that guy.
What did you play? One of those?
They invited me again, so I was on the show twice. Both times cops. One of them was a bad cop.
Uh-huh.
And one of them was a good cop who gets blown away.
Look, I'm looking at your face. Dark hair, dark eyes, dark olive skin, good looking. Tell me, you're not blonde. Is it, what's the rose? I mean, how, when you go into a casting office, how do you buy it? You're always playing that same.
I tell them, I can be blonde, I can have blue eyes, contact lenses, but they won't buy it.
But, those roles.
I think it is, but I think.
Is it typecasting for you?
I think maybe, maybe not. You know, Andy Garcia's really doing a good job out there, and he opened the doors
uh-huh.
as a Cuban who plays an Italian.
So you're Latin.
Yeah.
You are Cuban,
Italian.
Italian, Cuban.
Yeah, my parents are Cuban, and
uh-huh.
then my grandmother and my grandparents, they're Italian.
Uh-huh. in Mambo King. Mambo King.
I think
what
those kind of
film.
Movies are, you know, they're
you
opening.
Dance? Do you dance?
A little bit.
Sing. Come on, Nick
Corey. Camelot.
If you would sing, Nick Corey, the way you look and dance.
I've been
you?
Working on my singing.
Have you?
Yeah. I've been working with Seth Riggs and...
He's one of the best.
Yes.
He's one of the best.
And slowly, you know, just it's a hobby thing for me. And when it gets good enough, I'll maybe...
Rainmaker. Come on. Tell me about Rainmaker.
Went to San Jose, did the Rainmaker, Burt Lancaster famous part.
Right.
And I kept wanting to do Burt Lancaster, but she, the director, said, don't do that. Do it like you. So I played a sort of a magical, mystical, you know, Starbuck. And it was a great experience. Opening night, stage fright. And
were you stage fright? Opening?
Yeah, opening night.
That's good.
I heard bad news on opening night.
Like what?
On my personal life, like my wife and me. And on opening night, I opened the door of coming onto the stage. And
right.
I do one of these numbers, and I thought, should I apologize or should I just keep going? And I was trained to just keep going. So I kept going and went on autopilot, which means you just say the words.
Say the words.
Don't worry, go through it. Because I wasn't there mentally. I was with
my
wife.
So your wife threw you off.
So what happens is, it was my fault because you have to really get...
Centered.
Yes, no phone calls on opening night. That's a little tip out there. So, after the opening night, it was a breeze every night just coming out. And I used to like the way this one actor prepared every night. He was an older fella. He'd prepare by doing crosswords.
That's great.
He'd concentrate by doing the crosswords. And then when his turn to come on, he'd be so focused. It was great.
Nick Corey, Hollywood's a tough place, like I'm saying it again. New York.
It's not too
Why not go to New York? Get the theater. Rob Lowe went to New York. He did theater in New York. He came back. He's doing real well now. He's going to be doing...
Here's the thing.
What is the thing? Why are young actors all come to California not to stay in Manhattan?
For me, I can only speak for myself, it was a disillusionment to me, which I'm glad.
Right.
I had an illusion of Broadway actor.
Right.
And then I didn't have that anymore. And then somebody called me and said, you know, there's a Broadway play, would you like to do it? And I said, no. Because I no longer had that thing, and I don't know what that is.
Wildcats.
Excellent movie.
Tell me about Wildcats. That was great.
Goldie Hawn, I love her. She's the best.
With Goldie Hawn. Tell me about
her. She's the best. She's the best.
You keep saying she's the best.
She's super nice. She gave me an opportunity. She always had me around her, so I'd be close to the camera. She just was there for me, and she'd act with me. She'd act off camera with me. She'd treat the extras great.
So you learned a lot watching these performers.
Yeah, she's a pro.
Sally Kirkland, you learned a lot from her.
She's a pro. She's an incredible method actress. I don't have to sort of react off of her.
named Edward Arnold.
Oh, the best.
Right.
Of course.
Well, his
Robert
son,
Stanwyck's movies.
His son was also in my class, and he wanted to be an actor,
uh-huh.
and we were double cast in this play. He played it one day.